Hello guys, today we talk about clutch, what should be issue give you or what problem, because clutch have a lot face. This means it's a lot, and today I'm show you, we have fun, I show you guys, hope like what I'm saying. So let's start. Dobra moi kochani, mamy tutaj poduszkę, którą wymieniłem. Zobaczmy ją. So guys, last time I replaced engine mount. That engine mount, it's old one. Have like 80,000 mile. Like you see, it's no crack, no leaking. Still, it is okay. So why I'm decide to replace engine mount? Maybe I'm show you, come inside. We are inside the car. I have couple of issue when my car start and couple of thing. That why I'm decide to change engine mount. Maybe I'm show you how engine start and what's going on. Right guys, I'm show you why I'm decide to replace the engine mount. I have another one. So we change for driver, for passenger side as well, because I living in Scotland, that's why we have right sides. So let's going on how my car starts. So I have bottle. I think it's now before change the mount. Is slightly better. When I push gas, as well bottle shake. So best idea, check engine mount, take out and watch how your engine mount look. I'm decide to replace, so I'm happy. I'm replace another one, we see how going on. But I have another issue, and I think it's this is clutch. When I press gills one, sometimes when I'm start, I have little shake. But this one, I think it's this is clutch. Engine mount, you can check as well. Put handbrake on and start. You see how engine shake. I go to car and you look guys and you tell me. So of course you can come inside the cab, put press gas, and somebody look can motors very bad shake, or put handbrake on and start move, you see how movement is. I go to car, you guys watch. Like you see guys, I think it's no bad, this is no bad, but anyway I'm replace next soon, I'm replace another engine mount and we see it is better or no, because it's driver side, it's already new, and probably next weekend if I've got time and weather, because like you see guys, it's wet and rain and we replace another engine mount. So my clutch, like you see, when I press gills one, I try start and I have shake. This is probably clutch. But another issue, or so popular issue, what you can have, this mean it's slipping clutch. I'm show you how diagnostic and check then your clutch it's slipping. Always it is RPM go up, but speed no. Then you have slipping clutch. Come to car, we go drive. All right, guys. Now we talk about slipping clutch. How check
of course, if you drive and you see you want speed and RPM go up, but your speed still the same, this is 100% your cyclic clutch. So how diagnostic that when you buy or check car? So start the engine, handbrake on, gears one first, push gas and try move. If your car won't move and back car go down, this means it's probably it's still clutch be good.
So one more time, what we do, start the engine, gears one, handbrake on, pedal, clutch off, gas, and you look. Car go down, RPM no go crazy. Okay guys, so next thing, how you can check the clutch. So you put, you drive 30 kilometers, 20 mile, put high gears, like 5 gears, and press the acceleration gas pedal. If your speed go up and RPM very slow go up, this means it's clutch okay. If your speed no go up but RPM go up, this means it's your clutch slipping.
Alright guys, so what we do? High gills on, small speed and press gas pedal. Like you see, it's speed go up but RPM no crazy go up. So this means it's start clutch, no slipping and don't have problem.
So guys, so this moment you know how check your slipping clutch. Gears one, handbrake put on, if car go down, RPM no go down, no go up, this means it's your clutch should be okay. Or take drive, high gears, small speed and press gas. If speed go up and RPM very very slow go, this means it's your clutch no slipping. Or maybe it's really bad, it's your already slipping when you drive and you see RPM speed slow, then 100% clutch, so you need to replace clutch. Another issue what you can have, this is, don't know how called, this is pump what push the clutch, probably leaking, and you have soft pedal or pedal go down, then possibility your clutch as well slipping and you have to replace everything. Tesla. No wood. But then your clutch pedal is very very soft. Possibility it's old fluid, brake fluid, it's there as well, it is more water and your pedal it's soft, but I don't think so because it's no much pressure there, but as well it is good replace the brake fluid over there. So another problem, another phase clutch, this is possibility your gills no come in, and this is so many question and so many check and so many question, and this is clutch or gearbox. So we go inside the car and show you guys another problem what you can have, this is gears no come on. You come on the morning in the car, close door, won't go to work, press start, and what's happened? Clutch on, gills no come, you have problem. Gills too, no problem. So what can be?
So it's two possibility. It's one, you can use the car because some problem on, if you come to light, street light, you stop the car, put gills for neutral, then you won't start, go and
no one come. Number two, it's come. Number one, no. So you try push clutch three time. If come, this mean it is clutch.
So right guys, so what's happen if you start engine and
you try push gills, clutch on, gills, and no, nothing happen here, nothing won't come. You try press clutch and still the same, absolutely concrete. So this is clutch or gearbox. So how I am check this one? Switch off the engine, press clutch and push the gills. If engine no work and gills come in, this mean it's this is clutch. If engine no work, you press couple of time pedal and gills still no come, this is probably a different thing.
Okay guys, we know it's engine mount. If you put gills, put clutch off and your car shaking, this is probably more clutch, but it is good idea check as well engine mount. I already told you how we talk about slipping clutch, so you know guys how check this thing. Another thing, it is bearing, clutch bearing. So clutch bearing, if you push the clutch, you drive gills 2 or whatever, you won't change the gills, you push clutch and you hear noise, you put gills, clutch off and noise gone, this means it's this is bearing clutch. All right guys, so another issue what you can have, this is double flywheel. Everybody love double flywheel because it is expensive. First problem what double flywheel give you, this noise, hammer noise. Maybe I'm try do video, find video how noise work. But first one, you start the engine. Now we have Audi A67. It's absolutely quiet here, so you need open door.
When you switch off engine, you try hear. So I don't hear nothing. This means it's my double flywheels. It's still okay.
Of course can be worse. What this mean? If you on neutral and you hear hammer noise from your gearbox, that it's double flywheels. Possibility as well, one more thing you can have. When you push acceleration gas, your flywheel makes UFO noise, like woo, woo. This mean it is double flywheels noise. All right guys, so we know about double flywheels, we know about slipping clutch, what's happening if gills no come. So probably you have question how do, what to do, it's my clutch, my double flywheel live longer. Yes, you can do. So first, when you start the engine,
press clutch and start.
Why this is important? Double flywheel don't like if you start the engine and don't put clutch. Of course in a new car you can start if you don't press clutch, but old car it is possibility you start engine and don't press clutch. But if you don't do this, then your double flywheel live shorter. Next, if you go to street light, you put neutral.
Okay guys, if you come to light, street light, don't keep feet on the pedal. Put on the floor. If you of course have neutral. If you keep like that, your clutch leave shorter. Double flywheels don't like eco driving. If you eco, your double flywheels die quicker. When you change gears, should be minimum 2000 RPM, no down. If you change gears for 2000 RPM, should be fine, but double flywheels don't like echo. So clutch, if you park, you use just clutch pedal. Operation, if you have flat, just put one gears and put clutch off, then your car start. If you reverse, the same, just clutch. Don't use pedal gauge, because then you can burn the clutch. Of course, if you have up to hell, or this way, you need reverse, you need go up, you don't have choice, then you use pedal gas. But if it's flat, nice car parking, in supermarket, use just clutch, no use gas, like grandpa, and speed 5 mph. So I think guys that everything. So see ya next time, and remember, passion, love and family, just VAC family. See ya next time. Okay guy, you're still there. So probably you think, guys, what I'm do, can I replace the clutch? My problem is sometimes no worse, it is all the time the same. If I'm see it's worse, then I'm decide to replace. The same I speak class owner, he tell me it's he don't want to give me money for clutch. And he say it's actually that problem, it is so long time, and he say it is when he bought the car, he got that issue. And don't know, can I believe or not, but decide no replace, because Audi A67 have a big massive gearbox, and it is under the car. Even I'm jack up and take gearbox for the chest, I don't know, can I go out under the car. So if that be like Superb or Passat gearbox, it's on the side, and probably I will do this drive and check what's going on. So see you next time.